Alright, welcome to Soul Keep It Fit YouTube. Today was my first day back in the gym. It's January the 16th. I have not been in the gym since the Saturday before Christmas due to me catching COVID right before the end of 2020. So that was great. Yeah, banged out legs today. Man, what can I say? Today was a workout. That's about all I can give it, man. I can't complain. I was able to get up and get back into it, man. It's definitely gonna be a grind. Man, I definitely gotta get my core back right, to get these squats back where they were before the end of last year. Because I just feel myself arching my back again like I used to do before I got any type of core stability, to try and compensate for the weight. And I had a lower back pump, which I know is a bad thing. So there's that. Outside of that, it was still a good workout. Legs tired. Was a little difficult towards the end there because... So normally I work out in the morning, and when I work out in the morning, I work out fasted. So I didn't eat this morning, but I had to stop by my mama's house to grab my workout bag because I ain't needed it this whole time. So, you know, ended up talking to her for a long time. So instead of me getting here at 10, I got here like at noon. So I hadn't eaten all the way until I finished my workout, which was at like 2:30. So I started to get a little bit of a headache. Outside of that, it was a good ass leg day. I'm not even gonna lie. Like it feel like it used to. It feel like it should. For my first day back, everything felt heavy. It didn't take that much, you know, to feel exhausted. I guess I should get some type of light on my face. But all in all, man, it was still a good day. You know, dopest thing about it, man, is the excitement on the people that were at the gym, the excitement on their face to see me back. You know, CeCe, Kayla, Rendy, Christine, Robert, you know what I mean? Like, it was just, you know what I mean? Like, it's the, especially Rendy and Christine, man, the genuine excitement for me to be back coming from the owner of the gym, you know what I mean? It's just, I don't know, man. It's just one of another reasons why, like, I'll never go nowhere else, man. It's just, you know what I mean? Like, unless, like, I had to move or some shit like that, but I wouldn't give a damn. Like, if I had to move and, like, for whatever reason and train at, like, a different gym or something, like, I just had to move out of the city or whatever, the state or whatever, like, no matter what, I don't care if I couldn't come and train except for, like, once a year or, you know what I mean, like, once a month at Metro, bro. Like, I would always keep my membership. There's no way. And there's no way I would ever stop striving to help the castle be better than what it already is. You know what I mean? Because, bro, like, I'm a loyal person. I'm built like that. You know what I'm saying? So, for me to have started training, you know what I mean, like, as recently as I did up here, and for me to be training here a little over a year as a trainer, the amount of love that I get from them, bro, it's unmatched, man. It's just something you can't buy. I don't know, man. It's just one of those things where when you get, you know, older in life, you know what I'm saying, older in your mind and wisdom, and just, you know what I'm saying, you start learning about the important things in this thing that we call life or whatever, you start to learn, man, it's going to be a lot of fake shit that you're going to be exposed to. It's a lot of fake people you're going to run into, a lot of fake love. And it's going to be rare that you meet a person or people that have your genuine best interest at heart. You know what I'm saying? Like, when I first started training up here, you know what I mean? I was kind of nervous because I ain't really had no huge guy. Well, shit, fuck it. I ain't even lie. I didn't have no clientele. I had, like, one person. I had one client at the time I started training, and Randy was like, man, you know what I mean? Like, when I told him I wanted to be a trainer up there, like, you know what I'm saying, on paper and, you know, sign my contract or whatever, he was like, man, you know what I mean? Like, I've been waiting on you, you know what I'm saying? Like, because he had saw me training my client before, you know what I mean? And it was my first time actually, you know what I'm saying, training a client in a gym. So I didn't know the procedure until, like, I read a post on Instagram that was like, you know, it was like three ways to know if your trainer's real or not. And one of the ones was that they sneak and train at a gym. They sneak and train you at the gym. Like, they don't have they're not on the contract or whatever. And I was like, oh shit, I didn't realize that was a thing. And so, shout out to Dan, you know what I'm saying, Hunt. But he was like, man, you a trainer up here? And I was like, nah. He was like, you should be. And he put that bug in my ear, you know what I mean? I went and talked to Randy, and you know, when I talked to Randy, he was like, man, I've been waiting. He was like, I knew you were coming. He was like, I just waiting on you. And so, you know what I mean? Like, he was like, man, you know, just, he was like, and he, you know, he gave me my paperwork, gave me the contract to read over and stuff, and let me know what was what and everything like that. And let me turn this air back off, actually. He let me know what everything was as far as the contract and everything. And he was like, you know, he's like, how many clients you got? I was like, man, like one. He was like, don't worry about it. He was like, man, we'll get you on your way. You know what I mean? Like, you get this, you get that, and we'll fill you up. And bro, when I tell you, he ain't let me down. Like, he gave me one of his clients when, you know what I mean? Like, when that had to change, he gave me one of his, you know what I mean? I know Christine has handed me, like, we have a sign up, you know, when you're looking for a trainer, like a paper that you fill out. I know she brought me at least three or four. It might have been more than that. You know what I mean? And then it's just having people that want to see you succeed genuinely. You can't beat that shit, bro. Like, you know what I mean? And the fact that, you know, I can bounce ideas off of him, and he's always receptive, you know what I mean? Like, if I ask him a question, he's always got an answer for me, you know what I mean? Or he'll tell me where I can go to find it, you know what I mean? And he listens on different things that I bring up to him as far as business and things that I feel like could make the gym, you know what I'm saying, a little bit more popular, bring us in a little bit more revenue, you know what I'm saying? And just give it a bigger stamp in the city, you know what I mean? The stamp that I feel like it deserves, the level that I would love to see it at. Cause I feel like if when you come to Fort Worth, when you hit the city limits, the number one thing you should know about as far as like working out is the castle. And that's the level I'm going to help get it to. You know, that's a goal, and shit, literally every goal I've ever had in my life I've hit. And I ain't saying that to brag. It's just, I'm no different than anybody else, man. When you put your mind to it and you actually put your work to it, it's going to happen, man. Believe that. You know what I mean? It ain't going to never happen on your time. It's going to happen when it's supposed to. But it's going to happen. So, but yeah, that's all I got for right now. I'm going to head home. I'm going to put in a few of the clips of my squat. I didn't record everything. I just really wanted to zone in and get to it, man. I did squats. I did leg curls, supersetted with some lunges. I started off with body weight, and I was like, nah, let me go and get some weight. So I did it with 15s. And then I did leg press and some leg curls, and I kind of just called it a day after that. I started getting a headache because, like I said earlier, I usually train earlier in the day. But like I said, I took too long to get here, so I was kind of training on an empty stomach, basically, so I got hungry, and I started getting a headache. So, you know, kind of an OG call, if you will. You know what I mean? Like, you don't want to be training. That's your body. You got to listen to your body, man. My body was telling me, hey, we need some food, otherwise we're going to go on and shut it down for you. So, you know, I just listened to my body and had a great leg day. But it's the first video, more to come. And I'm gonna holler at y'all later. Thank you.
All right, so first workout back done. Woke up this morning at 182, as you can see. Probably like 181, got a camera in my hand. Just got the little tripod thing still attached to it. Just wanted to close out the video. I was supposed to do this last night, fell asleep. I'm really, really sore today. My quads hurt. Hamstrings feel a little tight. Supposed to do back with Billy on Monday. Today is Sunday, yesterday was Saturday. So we're gonna see how that goes. We got deadlifts, and then we're gonna run through a back day. So I'll get some footage for that. But until then, till next video, y'all stay light, man. So I'll be fit out.